Hello everyone. I welcome you in my second lecture of this chapter, number 1, Noun and its types. In my previous video, I have explained about what noun is and what are the basic types of noun that you are going to study in this chapter. So, firstly, we should go with a quick revision of what we have studied in the previous video. Noun is a name of person, place, animal or thing. Whatever you see around yourself, that is noun. Second, what are the types of noun? So the types of nouns were common noun, proper noun, abstract noun and the collective noun. So I have explained various examples and I think that you people are able to recognize the difference between the common, pers, proper, abstract and collective noun. So today in this video, I am going to teach you how to form abstract noun. So first of all, you need to know what is abstract noun. Abstract noun are those noun which you cannot see, those noun that you can't touch. Abstract noun are those noun which you can only feel. For example, if you are having a feeling for someone, if you hate any person, so you can't see that hateness. It is an abstract noun. So today I am going to explain you how to form abstract noun. So abstract nouns can be formed by adjective, formation of abstract nouns. So this is a topic that we are going to study today. Formation of abstract noun. Now, how you can form abstract noun? You can form abstract noun using adjectives, using verbs, as well as using common noun. So in English language, in English grammar, there are certain rules to form abstract noun. So today we are going to I am going to discuss those rules with you all. So first of all, I have said that we can form abstract noun by three different parts, that is adjective, verbs and common noun. So one by one and step by step, I am going to teach you that how you can form abstract noun using all these words. So first of all, I am going to explain you how you can form abstract noun using adjective. For example, if I am writing any sentence here, that is, Ram is a honest. So the word honest, what is the word honest? Is a honest boy. So the word honest is an adjective. It is an adjective. Because this is a quality of the person, the boy Ram. Ram is a noun and his quality is honest. So, adjective, this honest is adjective. So, we are studying how we have to form abstract noun from adjective. So, Ram is a honest boy. Now, if I am writing another sentence, that is, Ram is known. For his honesty. As you can see in the second sentence, the word honest is converted into honesty. So here the word honesty is not adjective. The word honesty is not adjective. What it is? It is an abstract noun. It is an abstract noun. I can give you another example also. For example, if I am saying Rohan is a punctual boy. Punctual means someone who is always on time. And his punctuality leads him towards success. His punctuality leads him to success. So the word punctual, it is an adjective. And when we are writing punctuality, when we are adding the ty in the word punctual, so that means that is not adjective. That is an abstract noun. So I am going to tell you different types of rules that how you are going to form abstract noun using the adjective. So, first of all, try to make notes. If possible, I am going to provide you rules. There are at least 5 rules how you can form abstract noun using adjective. Rule one is you can form abstract noun by adding ty. Pay attention everyone, by adding ty y, c y, r y, or y. Now, here you have to see that we are learning how to form abstract noun using adjective. Here we are using adjective. The first thing that we are studying, that is using adjective, formation of abstract noun using adjective. So this is the rule number one, where you need to add ty, cy, ry, and y. Now just pay attention. If I am writing any word, that is cruel. So cruel, can anybody of tell me what is cruel? Cruel, cruel, it is an adjective. This is, and what is this? This is an adjective, because first of all we are learning how to form abstract noun using adjective, and this is the rule number one for that, where you have to add ty, cy, ry, and y. So I have written the word cruel here. So now here in cruel, when I am going to add ty in the word cruel, so it will convert into cruelty. Now tell me, is it adjective? No. Now this adjective has converted into an abstract noun. Similarly, if I am writing another example, that is efficient. If I am writing another example, that is efficient. Efficient means, this is an adjective. Now, how it will get converted into an abstract noun? In this, I have to remove this T and I have to add CY. That is the second part. So, it will get converted into an adjective. Efficiency. So, this is an abstract noun, where we have deleted the T and we have added CY. Now, I can quote one more example for RY. For example, if I have written brave, it is an adjective. For example, Rohan is a brave boy. So brave kya hai? Brave is adjective hai. This is an adjective. So here we are going to add ry to make it an abstract noun. Brave plus ry is equals to b-r-a-v-e-r-y, bravery. So here this was adjective, and now this is adjective, and this word bravery, this is an abstract noun. Because we have added ry to this adjective, and now this has get converted into an abstract noun. Similarly, I can give you one example for this, where we have to add y. For example, I have written difficult. So difficult, the abstract noun for difficult is difficulty. So in difficulty, we have to only add difficult y. We have to only add y. So this is rule number one, how you have to form abstract noun using adjectives. Like cruel plus ty gives us an abstract noun cruelty. Efficient, where we have to delete the y and we have to add cy. So efficient gives the abstract noun efficiency. Brave plus ry gives the abstract noun bravery. Difficult, where we have to just add y, it gives the abstract noun difficulty. So I hope this much is clear to you all. This was rule number one, where you are supposed to add ty, cy, ry, and y. Now moving towards the rule two, please try to note it down somewhere so that you can reread it, and it is going to be very beneficial for you when you are going to solve the worksheets. So I request you all to note it down, jot it down with me only. Now moving towards the rule two. Now moving towards the rule two. These rules are for the formation of abstract noun using the adjective. So rule two is by adding the suffix ness. Now first of all, you have to understand what is the meaning of suffix. Suffix means the words that we add after any word to change the meaning of that particular word. Those words are known as suffix. For example, we can add N-E-S-S after any word to change the meaning of that particular word. So in the formation of abstract noun using adjective, this is rule number two, where you have to add the suffix N-E-S-S to change the adjective into the abstract noun. For example, I am writing the first word kind. Kind plus ness. Kind is an adjective. The person is kind. That is the quality of the person. So this is an adjective. Plus any double s, according to the rule that we have to add suffix any double s. So it is going to give you kind. It is going to give you the word kindness. And this is an abstract noun. Similarly, dark. Darkness will give you darkness. Darkness. Soft plus ness is going to give you softness. So this was rule number 2. This is very easy. Here you have to just add the suffix any double s. Moving to rule number 3. Rule 3. Now in rule 3, what you have to do in rule 3, you have to replace T. You have to replace the letter T by C E. Now here you have to pay attention. You have to replace the letter T by C E. For example, intelligent. Intelligent I have written here. So this is an adjective. Now what I have to do, according to the rule, I have to replace T by C. So I will replace this T from the word intelligent. So I am going to write INTELLIG. It will be EN. I have removed this T. Now what I have to add? I have to add intelligence. So this word intelligent, it is an adjective. And when we are writing it as this intelligence, this is an abstract noun. Similarly, another example for rule 3, that is obedient. Obedient. Here also we are going to follow the same rule, replace T by CE. So just cut this T. This is going to be OBDIEN. T ko aapne kaat diya. So no need to add T. It is CE. So this is obedience. So this is an abstract noun. So I hope that rule number 2 and rule number 3 is clear to all of you. In rule number 2, you have to add the suffix any double s. For example, kind plus ness, kindness, dark plus ness, darkness, soft plus ness, softness. So these were the adjectives, and when you have added these suffix and these adjectives, so it get converted into an abstract noun. These all are the abstract noun. Rule number 3, you have to replace T by C. For example, intelligent, when you will replace this T with by C, it will get converted into intelligence. Similarly, obedience will get converted into obedience. Now moving towards the rule number 4. What is the rule number 4 in the formation of abstract noun from adjective? So rule number 4 says, this is also very easy, but you have to pay attention. Rule number 4. Here you have to add by adding at th. Here you just have to add th. But there is there are few changes other than this. For example, if the word is strong, S-T-O-R-O-N-G, strong. So this is an adjective, and the abstract noun for strong is strength. So here what you can see that you have added the word th, but in place of the vowel e, the vowel o, you have written e. So in rule number 4, you have to add th with few changes in the vowel. For example, if I am writing long, so the abstract noun for long is going to be length. So here also what you have done, in place of this vowel o, you have to write the vowel e and you have to add th. Okay, so then moving towards the rule, last rule of this formation of abstract noun from adjective. Last rule for this is, you have to simply delete y by deleting y. For example, if I have written worthy is an adjective. Now what you have to do, you have to delete the word y. So it will get converted into worth. So this was an adjective, this is an adjective, and this is an abstract noun. If I have written the word greedy is an adjective. I have to delete the word y. So it will get converted into greed. Greed is an abstract noun. Alright, I hope that these 5 rules are clear. after this, this was the formation of abstract noun using the adjective. After this, the second thing that we have to study, that is the formation of abstract noun using verb. So moving towards our second topic. So these were the five rules that how you have to form abstract noun using adjective. Now moving towards the second topic, that is formation of abstract noun using verbs. So here you have to pay attention. For example, if I have written one sentence, that is we are working hard to complete the verb. So here the word complete, this is a verb. This is a verb. Now, if in continuation I am writing, it is nearing completion. So the word completion is not a verb. This is an abstract noun. So here also I am going to give you at least five rules that how you have to form abstract nouns using verb. So rule number one, where you have to add by adding suffix, ion, by adding the suffix ion. Now how you are going to add the suffix ion? For example, the word I have written act, the word act, it is a verb. So in this you have to add ion. This is going to give you action. So the word action is an abstract noun. Similarly, invent, this is a verb. Invent, this ion. We are moving according to the rule, because here in first rule you are supposed to add ion. So invent plus ion, it is going to give you invention. It is an abstract noun. So this was rule number one. If you talk about rule number two, so in rule number two, what you have to do in rule number two, you have to add by adding tion, sion. You have to form the abstract noun using these suffix tion, sion with slight changes. Because here are some changes where you are going to add these suffix into the verbs with slight changes. For example, if I have written the word locate. So if you are going to add tion in the locate, so what are the changes that you have to make? You have to delete the word e, the letter e from this. That is location. It is going to be location. Similarly, if I am writing declare, so in declare, this is verb, so what is going to be the abstract noun of this word? It is going to be declaration. So here you have to add a, and you have to remove this e letter, and you have to add a plus tion. Similarly, I can give you one more example of rule number two, where you have to add tion, sion, but you have to make some changes. You have to make few changes. For example, I am writing decide. So this is a verb, and what is going to be the abstract noun for the word decide? It is going to be decision. So here you have added this suffix sion, and what are the changes that you have made? Deci. You have deleted this word de, and you have deleted these two letters de, and you have added the suffix sion. So this was rule number two, where you have to add the suffix tion and sion with few changes. Now rule number three for the formation of abstract noun using the verb. The rule number three says adding, in rule three you have to add ence or ance or c. Now here you have to pay attention, this is quite complicated. Here you have to add these three suffixes: enc, anc, or c. For example, I am writing neglect. So this is a verb. What is going to be the abstract noun of this? Negli. Now I have deleted the word ect, and in place of this, sorry, not word, in place of these letters, I am going to add ince. I have used this rule. So neglect get converted into negligence. Then after, if you are writing enter, so the abstract noun for enter is entrance. So what you have done in this? ENT. This much you have used. After that you have added a letter R and ANCE. Entrance. Similarly, how you have to use CE? For example, I have written silence. So this is a verb. That was abstract noun. I have written silent. This is verb. And what is going to be the abstract noun of this word? Where we have to delete the letter T and we have to add CE. So the abstract noun is going to be SILENCE, silence. So this was rule 3, where you have to add ENC, ANC, CE in the verb. But there are few changes that you have to follow. Moving towards the rule number 4. Rule number 4 in the formation of abstract noun using the verb. Rule 4. Now, rule 4 is very easy. You have to simply add ment, meant. For example, if move is written, so move is a verb. So the abstract noun is going to be movement. If engage is written, so engage is a verb. Engage plus ment, meant. So this is going to be engagement. Rule number 4 is very easy. Whatever verbs are given there, you have to simply add ment, meant. For example, improvement, government. So after this, rule number 5, you have to add ing. In rule number 5, you have to add ing. For example, suffer. Suffer is a verb. Suffer plus ing gives you suffering. Suffering. Similarly, if learn is written there, learn is a verb. Learn plus ing is going to give you the abstract noun learning. Alright. So these were the rules for the formation of abstract noun using the verbs. So that were the rules of formation of abstract noun using verb. Now this is the last topic where you have to understand how we have to form abstract noun using common noun. And this is very easy using common noun. How you have to form abstract noun using common noun. So it is very easy. There is only one rule. You have to add by adding hood. H-O-O-D, hood. So in this way you are going to form abstract noun using the common noun. For example, if I have written child is a common noun. Child plus hood, H-O-O-D, hood. So this is going to be childhood. So childhood is an abstract noun. Similarly, this is rule number 1. Really, I think only two rules are there. By adding hood, child plus hood is going to give you childhood. So then sister. Sister plus hood is going to give you sisterhood, motherhood. You can take any example, any common noun, and you have to just add hood, and that is going to give you the abstract noun. Sisterhood. Okay. So this is very easy. And the second rule is that you have to add, only two rules are there in this topic, that how you have to form abstract noun using common noun. In first rule, you have to add hood. And in second rule, you have to add by adding dom. D-U-M, dom, sorry. by adding these three letters, D-O-M. For example, I have written king. King is a common noun, right? Plus dumb. So it is going to be kingdom. This is an abstract noun. For example, I have written duke plus dumb. So this is going to be dukedom. So these are the two rules that you have to use when you want to form abstract noun using the common noun. Rule number one, where you have to add hood. For example, you can take any common noun and you have to just add hood. Child plus hood, childhood. Sister plus hood, sisterhood. Rule number two says add D-O-M, dumb. King plus dumb, kingdom. Duke plus dumb, dukedom. So students, these were the few rules and few ways of formation of abstract noun through adjectives, through verbs and by common noun. In adjective, I have given you 5 rules. Similarly, in the formation of abstract noun using the verb, I have given you 5 or 6 rules, and these are the 2 rules in the formation of abstract noun through common noun. So I hope that you people are going to understand these all terms terms and rules very clearly, and after this I'm going to provide you the worksheet in the description box. You have to download the worksheet from the description box and you have to solve that. Thanks for watching my video. Please like the video, subscribe our channel. Thank you.